Welcome dear student. Today we will continue with the lesson Human Body and Organ System, and this is a part 4 video of this lesson. In our previous video student, we have learned about the circulatory system, right? And today we will going to learn about the blood and components of blood, and we will going to see the blood groups also. So let's answer one question. What flows out when we have an injury? The student, just observe the picture. When we get injured, blood starts to flow out very fast and it does not stop for a long span. That means when we have any type of injury, so blood will flows out of that area, out of the cut area. Now let's see about what is a blood. So blood is a red colored fluid material. That means it is present in a liquid state. And oxygenated blood is deep red colored and it is salty in taste. Now what is oxygenated blood? The blood we have learned in our previous video also. The blood which contains more amount of oxygen with it, it is called as an oxygenated blood. So color of it is deep red colored and taste is salty. Now its pH is 7.4. So what is pH? So it pH is a measure of acidity or alkalinity of the solution. So pH of the blood is 7.4. That means it is slightly alkaline in nature. Now we will see or we will learn the composition of the blood. So you can see on the picture, you can see one picture on the screen that a blood contain a plasma, a yellow colored liquid is called as a plasma, okay? And the blood cells like white blood cells and red blood cells and platelets also. So these four are the composition, main composition of the blood. So now let's study one by one. So first components of the blood is plasma, and it is present in major quantity in the blood. So student, blood is, this plasma is pale yellow in color and it is very clear and pale yellow in color, and the nature of the plasma is slightly alkaline. That means it is, its pH is more than about 7.4 or less than it, okay? And it contains 90 to 92% of water, 6 to 8% of protein, and 1 to 2% of inorganic salts and other components. Now here we can see the albumin, globulins, fibrinogen and prothrombin. So these are the proteins which are present in the plasma, Now this fibrinogen is secreted or it is produced in the liver, and prothrombin. So these fibrinogen and prothrombin helps in the blood clotting process. Now what is blood clotting? When we get injured or cut in our body, the body part, from dead body part, what happened? The blood flows out from that injury, okay? And to prevent the excessive bleeding, blood starts clotting. And for the clotting of bloods, these two proteins are helps. Now next is inorganic ions like calcium, sodium and potassium. And these ions, like these inorganic ions, helps in controlling the function of muscles and nerves. That means these has a control over muscles and nerves. So this was plasma. Now again here we have seen the plasma and blood cells, okay? So within the plasma we have proteins 7% like albumin, globulin and fibrinogen. So these are the protein which are present in the plasma. And in the blood cells we have red blood cells, white blood cell and platelet. So plasma is different and the blood cells are different. It is about 45%. Now let's study the different types of blood cells like red, white and platelet. So these red blood cells are no short form is RBCs, and this also known as a erythrocyte. You can see the picture alongside picture, you can see the red blood cell, that is erythrocyte. Now these are small circular and enucleated cell, that means these are the cells which are present in which nucleus is absent, and these cells appear red due to hemoglobin. So that means these cells are red. Why? Because of the presence of hemoglobin. That means it contains iron, and oxygen dissolves in blood due to presence of hemoglobin. And these are essential for transferring of oxygen in blood. Now 50 to 60 lakh RBCs are present in each of the are present in each cubic millimeter of blood. And RBCs are produced in red bone marrow and live for about 100 to 127 days. So this was about the erythrocyte. Now we will learn the next type of blood cells, that is white blood cells, and the short form of it is WBCs, and it is also known as leukocyte. You can see the picture in right hand side. The blue colored is the nucleus, and this is a blood cells, white blood cell. Okay, now let's study about it. So these white blood cells are large, that means these are large as compared to RBCs, and these are nucleated cell, that means nucleus is present. You can see the blue colored nucleus, okay, and these are the colorless cells. Now 5000 to 10000 WBCs are present per millimeter cube of the blood, and these are produced in the red bone marrow. Now what is a red bone marrow? These are the soft and sponge like tissue present in the center of the bone. And in this bone marrow, the WBCs and RBCs are present. Now WBCs acts as a soldier. That means when any virus or bacteria comes or enter in our body, these WBCs get activated, and these are protect our body from that pathogens or viruses and bacterias. And these cells attack the pathogen entering our body, and they protect us from microbial diseases. That means they protect us from any of the disease causing by the bacteria and viruses. Now here we can see the five types of white blood cells. So first is monocyte, eosinophils, basophil, lymphocyte and neutrophil. So these are the five different types of white blood cells. Next we have is platelets. Now these are extremely small and disc shaped, and about 2.5 to 4 lakh platelets are present per millimeter cube of blood. And the function of these platelet is they are participate in blood clotting process. That means if we get any type of injury, these platelets helps to clot the blood, and they stop the excessive flow of the blood by clotting of blood. Okay, so you can see the erythrocyte, leukocyte and platelets. These are the very small shaped cells. Now student, let's learn about the function of blood. So first is transport of gases. Now oxygen is carried via blood from lungs to cells in various parts of body, and carbon dioxide from tissues to lungs. Next function is transport of nutrients. That means simple nutrients like glucose, amino acids, fatty acids are taken up by blood from wall of alimentary canal. Alimentary canal means from mouth till the root, from mouth till anus or the excretory part of the body, and then transported up to each cell in the body. Next is transport of waste material. So in our body, like nitrogenous waste like ammonia, urea, creatinine are released by tissues into blood, and which carries those to kidney for excretion. That means they are removed out from our body. Next is protection. Antibodies are produced in the blood and they protect the body from microbes and other harmful particles. That means they protect our body from the any infection caused by bacteria and viruses. Transport of enzymes and hormones. In blood transport the enzymes and hormones from the site of their production to the site of their action. Thermoregulation. So they maintain or body temperature is maintained constant at a 37 degrees Celsius by vasodilation and vasoconstriction. That means by decreasing and increasing the blood pressure, the temperature of the body is maintained at 37 degrees Celsius. Next is they maintain the balance of minerals like sodium, potassium in the body. And if bleeding occurs at the injury, platelets and a protein called fibrinogen of the blood form a clot and seal the injury. That means they have the defensive function also. Next we have a human blood group. So let's see what are the blood groups. So depending upon the proteins like antigens and antibody, different blood groups are formed. That means we have antibody and antigens. On the basis of these, the blood groups are classified. So there are four main groups like AB, 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 and O. So these are the four main blood groups. And besides, there are two types of Rh factor, that is Rh positive and Rh negative. So on the there are four types of blood groups: A, B, AB, and O. And besides, we have positive and negative rhesus or Rh factors also. So on the basis of the positive and negative factors, we have like A plus, A minus, and like B plus, B minus, AB plus, AB minus, and next O plus and O minus. So these are the total 8 types of blood group depending upon the positive and negative Rh factor. Now blood donation. So blood donation, if a person meets an accident, bleeding occurs through wounds. And many times what happens, blood transfusion is necessary during the surgical operation. That means they required the blood during the any type of the accidental or surgical operation. And similarly, blood is transfused in case of patients of anemia, thalassemia, cancer also. And blood transfusion is carried out by compensate the blood shortage in the body, and this is called as blood transfusion. So from where the blood is supplied for blood transfusion? So first, blood supply is by the blood bank. Now blood is collected in body banks, blood banks. Blood is collected in blood banks by specific method from the healthy persons, and these are supplied to the needful persons. If the collected blood is not be used immediately, it can be stored for some days in refrigerator. Blood donor. Person who donates the blood is referred as a blood donor. And blood recipient. So person who receives the blood is referred as a recipient. So from these sources we get the blood, like blood banks from the blood. So on the screen you can see one table in which we have recipient and blood donor. So let's see. The person of the blood group O can donate the blood to the person having any other blood group, whereas the person, you can see in the picture also, in the table also. So whereas the person with AB blood group can receive the blood from the person with any other blood group. Okay, like O and AB, they can receive the blood from any of the blood donor. And hence the but A and B, there are the some restriction. A can get the blood from A also and AB also, okay, and but B can get blood from B and AB only, right? So and due to this property, that means O will receive blood from any donor, and AB can receive the blood from any O will donate the blood from any of the to any of the blood group, and AB will receive the blood from any of the blood group. Okay, so due to this, the O blood group is known as a universal donor. That means it can donate its blood to any of the recipient, any recipient having any group. And due to the AB, that means they can accept the blood from any of the donor. So due to this, the AB blood group is called known as a universal recipient. Now let's see the blood pressure. Now due to contraction, blood is continuously kept flowing through blood vessels due to contraction and relaxation of the heart. And due to contraction of the heart, what happened? The pressure is exerted on the wall of arteries and it is called as a blood pressure. So proper blood pressure is necessary to supply the blood in all parts of the body. Now pressure recorded, now here you can see the when heart is in relaxed position and when heart is in contracted. Okay, so when heart is relaxed, what happened? Heart is contracted, the pressure is called as a systolic pressure. But the blood pressure which is recorded during the relaxation is called as a diastolic pressure. So blood pressure of a healthy person is about 120/80 millimeter. Okay, blood pressure. So blood pressure of a healthy person is about 120/80 millimeter to 139/89 millimeter of Hg. And it is measured with the help of an instrument, sphygmomanometer. This type of instrument is called as a sphygmomanometer, and by this we can measure the blood pressure of a patient or any person. Now hypertension, let's learn about hypertension. It means the high blood pressure. So high blood pressure, then the normal, is referred as a hypertension, and it is due to the stress also. And in arteries of the person with hypertension, unnecessary tension develops and heart needs to perform more function than the normal condition in case of a hypertension. And both the systolic and diastolic pressure are high in hypertension. So in some of the cases, this hypertension can happen very severely, as it is created a tension on the walls of the heart. So you can see in the picture that during the normal blood pressure, the blood flows easily through the vessel, but in hypertension, what happened? Tension is created on the walls of arteries, and due to that, the blood may not flow easily through the vessels. You can see the shape of the arrow in normal situation and the shape of the arrow in hypertension. So this was all about this lesson, student. I hope you all have understood this lesson. And next chapter we are going to continue in our next video. Thank you, students.